Hello. You're looking at a figure by Steve Barber models, miniatures. I can't remember, I'm so sorry, Steve. So this is one of the loading figures. I have about 30 of them and three slightly different poses. The one on the right, let me just move there. So so this is actually all pared down metal, the ramrod and the bayonet were all connected. There's a lot of work. And I snapped the ramrod a few times and the bayonet, and it's still a bit fat, the bayonet angle bracket thing at the bottom, whatever it's called, bend. And then I kind of fixed it to his kepi. So what I've decided to do, I think this is the fifth one I've done, and they have different right arm sort of activity in the loading drill. The three poses I did, all sort of using ramrods, I think, or potentially using ramrods. I can always add a ramrod easily. I like the way his fingers came out, his front two, and his thumb, which are gripping the top of the ramrod. Just about see it, I suppose, there. But I really couldn't do a particularly good job on his face because it was very difficult to reach. I might have, yeah, I should maybe have put a little tiny bit of sort of off-white in his eye, but well, I think it looks okay, sort of, really, his face. Yes, that's better. So what I'm going to do now on the remaining ones, the fettling process, for example, this one on the left here, has well, so what I've done is I've just snipped off. Yes, I've snipped off the top of the ramrod and the bayonet, which was sort of fused together and connected, of course, to the hand. So I've removed all that. Still, I'll clean up the bottom part of the ramrod to separate it from anything. Well, from the tube, rather, sorry. Yes. No, there is no tube, sorry. Yes, I've just sliced off the bayonet completely at the top of the bayonet socket. But I've kept the ramrod and what's behind it sort of in fill. There's only to drill that out. Yes. It's difficult to make out what you're looking at here because it's so shiny. So then, once I've cleaned up all those bits behind the top of the musket, the bayonet, and cleaned his hand up and given it extended fingers a bit, continued them around and whatnot. And a ramrod on top. And a bayonet, of course. That's the final thing to add, probably. I'll just make one out of plastruct. So, yes, it'll speed up the whole process of feckling, because I thought I'd just do it as a challenge, but I've done it on the previous ones as well, I think. This degree of pairing, you know, getting the ramrod isolated on its own right thickness. So, yes, it's just too laborious. Bayonet and ramrod, which is just mad. So, let me get my fingers out of the way, I won't focus on it so much. Yes, I should be able to speed up production of these very nice figures. I had a go at the legs with the pliers, some various shaped pliers as well. Still sort of nice and baggy looking, which I think they were in the Union, most of the trousers of the infantry. The face is okay, it'll be fine. Once I've got smoke and things, he's going to see. And he's going to be in a firing line with probably about, well, the other figures doing the same sort of thing. And, I'll mix in some other manufacturers as well. Loading with ramrods, or maybe slightly ahead, just about to fire out the ready or something, the fast loaders. Yes, and so you're only going to really see the top parts of them anyway. They're going to be stood behind breastworks. I think I'll have a go at making the legs longer, just by kind of squashing them with some rounded pliers next time. Maybe reduce the waist a bit. Squash out. Pointy conical shaped nose pliers. I think they're made by Exacto. Good. Still, yes, just to make the legs a bit longer. Start with him. Might be a her. Anyway. Yes, he's perfectly acceptable, I think. Looks dirty and muddy enough. And plenty of black powder on his face. Dirt. And, yes, there would be black powder on the face and hands and the lips even from biting the cartridge, I imagine. Maybe some blood from artillery concussions. Sorry, it's my fingers are messing this up. I think I've probably gone on enough. Yes. Does look a little bit short. But you're only ever going to see the top of them anyway, so it doesn't matter. So I think great. I mean, the detail on these figures is so nice and pronounced. It makes up for people with slightly poor eyesight or whatever. Yes. Let's show him on the diorama. Right, thank you for watching. Bye.